Hello, fellow puffers. My name's Tamar Peterson. This is Doug the Dug. I just want to correct something that I noticed in one of my previous videos. I made the mistake of saying that the smaller the pipe, the hotter the smoke. Not true. Not true at all, in fact. Big and Burly in a Peterson Premier 309. Silver banded, but as you can see, the silver's certainly needing a polish. I'll get round to it or I'll get dirty there. Look. Nice one. What the fuck was I talking about? The bigger the pipe, the smoke. I'll start that again. The smaller the pipe, the hotter the smoke. That's fucking bullshit. Just a wee second. See this pipe here? Right? It's a Dutch pipe, it's a Big Ben Ranger. There's a tamper, right? I don't know how clear that's actually coming out, but that's how small that pipe is. It's not much bigger than a tamper. That's one of my best smokers. And you might say, well, you don't get much of your smoke out of that. But depending on what you're smoking, if you're smoking Reaver or a Condor Original Long Cut, you can get a good 30 minutes, even with 40 minutes, with a wee pipe like that, you know? Unless you're one of these idiots that puffs clouds of smoke everywhere, you know? But I'm sure you're not, you know? I'm always losing my bloody tamper. I don't know about you people, but every time I'm smoking my pipe, well, a good percentage of the time I'm smoking my pipe, I'll get up to do something and I always forget where I put the bloody tamper down. I can never find the damn things. Yeah, Big and Burly's a good smoke. I like this. It's got a full on flavour, you know. It doesn't take any prisoners when it comes to that Burly taste. And it's got a lovely nicotine kick. This is my new Burly pipe, but it's not a pipe I take outside, basically because it's big, not in the sense that the bowl's too big, but the actual pipe itself, you know, I can't imagine walking down the road with this hanging from my mouth, you know. Far too ostentatious. I'll put my teeth back in. Far too ostentatious, you know, for me, you know. It's a nice smoker. Something else that I noticed when I was reading the tobacco reviews, apart from so much fucking shite they say about blends being strong, that aren't they strong? I've read a lot of reviews of plugs and flakes, and a lot of people say, oh, you know, this is a good smoke, but I'll not smoke it again because it's a bother, you know, having to prepare the plug or having to prepare the flake or having to cut the twist, and, you know. I don't get that at all. I really genuinely don't. That's... But for me, part of the fun of pipe smoking is, you know, as well as the intense of pleasure I get and as well as the fact that I'm a total vitamin N freak, the whole ritual aspect of it, I mean, you get such a good smoke if you've got a nice plug or a nice twist, and when you think, you know, the ritual you go through, you know, like to cut up the twist and the plug and to rub it out and, you know, the whole thing, it's all part, the whole ritual aspect of it, it's all part of the enjoyment, you know, you got a really good smoke. You got a question, Doug, you know? You get two questions. It's all part of the ritual, part of the whole smoking experience for me, you know? Plus, plugs and twists are a... Bye, Doug. Plugs and twists are a slower burning smoke, so they're usually cooler. And they last, I don't say, longer. And the flavour's usually more intense in the plug or flake version. Air Tobacco than it is in the Ready Rubbed. Ready Rubbed Tobacco to me is like an instant meal. It's like the microwave meals that people buy when they can't even bother fucking cooking, so they just shove the thing in the microwave, you know, and then they sit in front of the TV watching some shite, you know, stuffing and doing, you know. That's the sort of people, it's like people that do that, that can't be bothered to prepare a nice plug and a nice flake, so they just buy the Ready Rub, because they're lazy bastards, you know. Probably too fucking fat as well, if you ask me, but, you know. That's all they fucking ready meals, you know what I'm saying? It's a lovely day here in Bucks. Beautiful sunshine, I'm just back in with the dug. I've been catching a few rays, you know, I've actually caught a wee bit of a tan, you know. Not bad. That's about all I have to say at the moment. Yeah, I think there's something else to rant about. Until next time, folks, happy puffing. Cheers.